Welcome back, Golly Vibes family, my brothers and sisters. Today's episode is going to be about Christian artist Lecrae. Just to give a little breakdown on Lecrae, I don't think I've ever talked about him on this channel before or brought him up. But he made a video recently where he's talking about he's been to a lot of Diddy parties. Not only Diddy parties, but a whole lot of different industry parties. And I'm going to show you guys that video in a minute. But just want to give a little background when it comes to Lecrae, as far as having an impact on my life when I was younger. When I came to the Lord when I was younger, I came to the Lord a couple different times, like two times before right now when I really started walking with God. But the two other times, you know, I came to the Lord, I presented my body as a living sacrifice, but I stayed in the outer court because I had no true spiritual father to feed me bread and meat, right? So I was just a baby getting taught by babies. And eventually, if a baby continues to drink milk, they die, they end up back in the world. You know, and that's what happened. But when I came to the Lord, though, Lecrae was somebody I used to listen to a lot. Actually, he was my favorite artist when I was little, you know. And I always appreciate that, you know, being able to have somebody to listen to when I was little like that. Now, granted, Lecrae may do some things now that I completely do not agree with. Like, he made he had a clothing line, he had an apparel that says you can quote Cardi B in Corinthians. Like, no, I do not agree with that at all. I don't know if he was trying to just trying to be controversial. I really don't know. I've never met the man. But yeah, there's different things I may not agree with. But there's things I don't agree with my brother in real life. You know what I mean? So it's like, I feel like as a body, as in the spiritual aspect, it's different. But it's just to show you a comparison of how I feel like he's a brother in the faith, but just doing these. I mean, it's like this, while I cry, you know, as far as like what I see. I also seen a video where he's saying that being gay is not a choice. Well, if that's the case, I would have to ask him, do you believe in deliverance? Do you believe somebody can be delivered from being gay, homosexual? If you don't believe that being gay is a choice, well, okay. Let's say, do you believe that somebody can be delivered then and come out of it? Because I've seen it. I believe that it's a spirit on people that gets attached to people. That's what I believe. That's what I know to be true. Because you can see people get delivered from it. You can see those spirits get casted out, and then those people have different preferences. But yeah, man, you know, I pray for this brother, you know, because when I first started listening to him, he was on fire, right? And then slowly he began to come into Hollywood. You know what Hollywood does? You know what Hollywood does? Them Diddy parties, as we're about to hear right now from him himself. And then we started seeing him with different secular artists, music videos, Ty Dolla $ign, who else? OK Cyrus, different people like that, you know? And it's just like, what's going on, Cray? You know? So yeah, man, I got to pray for people like this, man, who you feel like are shaky, you know? I never want to talk bad about the man or bash the man. If anything, just want to go and pray for the guy, you know. And you know, he even talks about how he struggled with different things, you know. So as a brother in the faith, you want to uphold people in the spirit even when they're going through different things. So yeah, you know, Lecrae was definitely somebody I used to listen to a lot. I know a lot of his old stuff. I don't really know his new stuff, simply off of a couple of different things I may not agree with. But, you know, definitely somebody to uplift in prayer. Amen. Because I know a lot of you probably don't agree with a lot of different things he's said either. You know, but however, you know, like I've said before with a lot of different people, they started on fire and then compromise sneaks in the back door. And it is sneaky, you guys. It is sneaky. But interesting enough about that. I want to talk about how he said he's been to a couple Diddy parties. Now, if you know Diddy, you know these parties be wild. And it's interesting because I've been to, well, when I was in the world, I've been to these different industry parties. You get what I'm saying? I actually been to a party where Diddy was at, and I rapped for Diddy in the back in the back parking lot, drunk as ever, rapping for Diddy. Who else was there? French Montana. Who else? Lil Durk. All these secular artists were there, and I was rapping for them. So I've been in these parties too, right? But let's see what he has to say, and I'll give you guys my perspective on what I've seen in and out of what he's talking about. We're gonna give you guys some different opinions and comments. So check this out.
I'm not gonna say nothing about this, but I'm gonna go ahead and say it. I've been to a couple Diddy parties. Now, I'm risking a lot by saying this because I know as soon as I say that, all the assumptions are gonna come in and if I don't say evil things were taking place, then I'm covering for them. And if I do say evil things were taking place, then I'm one of them ones like, yeah, Lecrae, expose it. You know what I'm saying? And I've been a lot.
I'm one of them ones.
The parties. I've been to Jamie Foxx. I've been with Snoop, T.I. Like, I've been to lots of places. Here's what I'll say. There are people who will test you. There are people who will see how far your limits are. And if you're willing to take a step, then they'll take two. I, in my personal experience, never saw anything where someone was like, you can't move any further unless you do X, Y, or Z. But what I did see was, if you do X, Y, or Z, well, keep coming because you're, you know, and that's how we all are. It's Psalm 1, right? It says, blessed is the man who does not walk in the counsel of the wicked, who does not stand in the way of sinners, who does not sit in the seat of mockers. You start walking, they gonna walk with you, and now you find yourself standing. They like, oh, you stand? Well, if you stand, come sit. Now, next thing you know, you're sitting. And so it was never.
Let's break down what he just said, because I know a lot of y'all are like, huh, stand, sit. What's going on here? My feet are getting tired. He's basically saying, like, he's never seen somebody say, like, hey, if you do this to me, then I can up jump your career, or I can take you further than where you're at if you, you know, go in a room with me and do this. But he's saying that pretty much he's seen people do things and then get taken further. Pretty much. Right? And you know, if you walk, they'll take you further and further into their crowd until you're like really with them, sitting down with them, and you shoulder to shoulder with them. That's one perspective. Another one is, you are some kind of way on the inside and you walk a little bit and you show them that you walk a little bit and they realize you with them, like you really doing what they do as far as nasty, disgusting things. Oh, you walking? Oh, okay. You sitting? Oh, okay. You do this? You a man? You mess with men? Okay. You sitting? You sit? You mess with men? Okay. You do this. You know, initiation.
There was a situation where I felt forced to sit. It was a situation where I was asked, do you stand? Do you stand? And I'm like,
do you do coke? Do you do pills? Do you mess with dudes? To break down what he's saying.
I'll stand. Oh, okay, cool. And then I was left alone. It's like, oh, he's not about that life. He's not with it. I'm leaving him alone. And this is what I'll say. And I won't say whose party I was at or what party, but this is a crazy situation, right? I was at one of these parties, and for me, I'll be honest, it was a mix of work, because this is oftentimes where you go to connect with people, where you go to meet people. And I have met people here and I have built bonds, and they have said, I have met actors and celebrities who said, man, thank you for being here. I needed your presence here. You're the reason why I know God is walking with me. And we've had conversations since where they're like, man, thank you so much. I appreciate you. Because how you going to be a light if you never in the dark? Now, if you cannot handle being in the dark, stay up out of certain places, right? Don't.
So, Lecrae saying, how you going to be a light if you're never in the dark? Meaning like, well, his perspective, how you going to be the light if you're not going into these dark places? However, the world is dark. You walk outside, you in the world. You don't need to go to a Diddy party or an industry party or a Snoop party or Jimmy or any of these secular parties. You don't need to do that to be a light of God.
Play tug of war by yourself. I never went to these events by myself. I was always with people who were walking in the light, and we always had a mission. It was never just to go in there and wild out and be stupid. But the other side of the coin is, yes, if I'm a human, so I'm frail. I'm gonna be honest with you. There was moments for me of like, oh my gosh, I'm here. I'm part of the crew. Like, look at me. Yes, I struggle with acceptance and wanting to be associated with greatness. And I got caught.
See, he talks about it himself. That compromise sneaking in and him wanting to give in to it. Wanting to be accepted by the world is compromise, brothers and sisters, no matter how you look at it. So he's saying, yeah, I struggled with wanting to be accepted. I struggled with, you know, liking the people I was, liking how I was around these people who, you know, before I was around them, I seen them on big stages. I seen how famous they were. I seen what they were doing. Like, now I'm around them. Like, man, I struggled saying, yeah, I'm in the crowd. You know what I mean? It's that compromise sneaking in.
Up in some of that nonsense internally, right? But you would have never known that. What I will say is that one particular party, lots of big names, there was an artist there who said, hey, Lecrae, around 1 a.m., make sure you're not here. And I was like, what? You just don't want to be here at 1 in the morning. And I was like, now, my pride kicked in, like, yo, you don't know me. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I can handle myself. Like, I'm not some little church boy who ain't never seen nothing. Like, I'm good. Like, you know what I mean? Like, what you talking about? Well, it's probably 12:30. I'm downstairs. I go downstairs to the studio. I come up out the studio, and I'm headed back upstairs to like the main area where everyone's kind of congregating and hanging out. And the music changed. It was like really hard and heavy at first, and then, you know, like jam and dancing music. And it was a little softer. You know, it was a little more sensual when I came out the studio and started going upstairs. And on my way upstairs, there's like this couch. I won't say how the couch is designed, because then that may give away whose party and whose house this was. There was a couch, and on the couch, I saw a couple of guys really going at it hard and heavy. And man, and I was like, oh. You know, my brain, I'm thinking, well, you know, the celebrity party, people do what they do. As I started moving upstairs, I passed them up, and I noticed that it wasn't just those two guys. It was more and more people just going at it. I was like, okay, it's time for me to roll. I'm going to grab my stuff, and I'm going to get up out of here. I did not know that's how this went down. So was that shocking? Absolutely. Was I?
I told y'all about these group situations. You know what's interesting? Actually, I'll talk about it after this.
Forced or coerced into anything? I was not. Why they felt that comfortable? I don't know. Maybe the invite list, they was like, yeah, all these people. I don't know. I'm shocked that it went down. But I've been to another situation, another person's party, celebrity party. And, you know, a celebrity tapped me on my shoulder and I was hanging out with them. And they was like, yo, nephew, you might want to go into the other party because this cabana, we about to close it up. And they closed up the cabana, and there was about three or four big name artists in there, and a whole bunch.
Nephew, he talking about Snoop Dogg. Listen, if he's trying to keep a name secret, saying somebody called you nephew, show sure isn't doing it. That's Snoop completely. Nobody else calls people nephew. A
bunch of ladies start walking in that cabana, and a security guard stood in front of the door. Hey, they didn't coerce me. They didn't ask me to come in. And everybody said, you probably should not be in this cabana. You probably just want to go back out there with the cocktails and the hanging out and the hobnobbing. And shout out to my guy, Brandon T. Jackson, man. Brandon T. Jackson, you know, I don't know what he's up to these days, but at this particular party, Brandon T. came up to me and he said, yo, man, like Satan will steal your soul in this industry, bro. And he was really like, I loved the fact that he felt like, he's like, I love your soul and your spirit, and I want you to thrive, Cray. I don't want you to get devoured out here. And I just appreciated that because for him, he was like, he has seen some detriments and some of the dark side of things. And he was like, yo, I want you to be taken care of. So I say all that to say, like, I never felt like it was some secret occult or secret, like, thing. I felt like there were areas at certain places that were like, hey, this could be the cocaine room. You know, I don't know. This could be the boom boom room. I don't know. But I never ventured into those places.
Or both.
You know, that wasn't my thing. And when I felt like something was moving to a level past where my witness or my, like, conscience would be messed with, I'm out of there. It's not for me. But somebody got to be in these places and spaces, right? Like, somebody got to be there, you know, to be, you know, in these environments. Now, I'm not saying somebody got to be at the strip club or don't misconstrue my words. What I'm saying is someone has to be in environments where people congregate and you can get to know them and you can build relationships. You know what I'm saying? These were not like, it's not just wild and people hanging from the ceilings everywhere. It's really just people hanging around by the pool, talking, having conversations. Some people dancing, some people walking. You know, oh, what's up, Jimmy Iovine? What's up, Madonna? Chris Brown? How y'all doing? You know, you talking. You have a whole conversation. You can share your whole testimony standing next to somebody by Jamie Foxx's pool. You know what I'm saying? So, again, it wasn't one of those situations where it was crazy. And I've been to tons of these industry events, like tons of them. So, it's what do you want to get yourself into? You know?
Tons of industry parties, Lecrae saying he'd been to. This is what I would say on that. I don't believe that any Christian needs to be at any industry party. I've been to them in the world. I've been to many industry parties. I've been to people's houses just there. I've been to Jamie Foxx's house multiple times. Different industry parties, man, it's... No, it's not for us. It's not for us. And people will say things like, well, Jesus hung out with the sinners. No, the sinners hung out with Jesus. The sinners hung out with Jesus. Amen. And they wanted to change. The Lord was saying things where they wanted to change. People at these parties go to these parties to do what they want to do. Now, I'm not saying that Lecrae didn't affect some people's lives. He could have. While he was there talking to different people. The Lord can use any situation. Trust me. You know? So I'm not saying the Lord's not didn't use him when he was in those situations. Nothing like that. You know, the Lord can use anybody in different situations. Do I believe that people should put themselves in those situations, though? No, I do not. I do not. And interesting enough, man, what I was going to say earlier was I seen that happen. Firsthand seen that happen when a party goes from a party to a sex orgy. And it's the craziest thing. I seen it happen at a hotel, in the middle of a hotel. I was in a hotel. I had no idea this was about to happen. And I was in the world, too. The music changed. People started taking off their clothes. Girls started doing things to guys. Like, it was, I was like, what is, like, I did one of these panoramas. Like, what in the world is going on with these nasty individuals? It's filthy in here. It was wild, man. Yeah, somebody I knew in there kissed somebody, right? And woke up with all kind of bumps in their throat. Oof. I still remember it. It's terrible. Terrible. But it happens. A lot of this stuff, you know, is sick. It's sick, you guys. That's why, you know, I thank the Lord every day that I'm out of that space. Because I used to go there to party. I used to go there to sell drugs. Just be in the mix and, you know, talk to many women. I thank the Lord that he truly pulled me out of that, you know. I've seen that life. I've lived that life. I've been a part of that life. I know exactly what that life entails. And not like Lecrae saying. Lecrae went there, he's saying, as a Christian. I went there in the world. I went there slinging cocaine with homies, with women. Really, really about that life. That's how I was in that life. You know, so you can kind of see where my passion comes from. You know, a lot of people say things like, well, you always yelling. Are you always, you too passionate? Like, no, you don't know my past. You don't know my story. You don't know what the Lord is taking me out of. If you did, if you seen some of the things I've seen, if you've been in some of the places I've been, if you know what the Lord took me out of, you'd be this passionate too. I know that if I would have seen me when I was in the world, I would have paid attention. The Lord pulled me out to reach other people like me. If I would have seen me going off like, who is this dude? Who is this dude really on fire for the Lord? I would have paid attention. It would have caught my ear for sure. The Lord knows what he's doing. The Lord is intentional. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Intentional. The Lord knows exactly what he's doing. And God is good. Amen. Yeah, man. You know, pray for Lecrae. I really don't know what he's up to these days. But, you know, I've seen different videos and different things like him saying being gay is not a choice that I don't agree with. I believe that it's a spirit on people. I don't believe that people are just born like in the same gender. I don't. No. That's like saying God made you that way. Simply not true. It's spirits on people, you know, and it's not just about homosexuality. It's different spirits on a lot of different people that cause people to sin. You just can see homosexuality in the public. So you can see what they're struggling with. A lot of people struggle with different things in private. Let's keep it 100. But it's spirits at the end of the day. The Lord gave us dominion and authority, though, to take over, to take over our mindsets. And we have to get to that point. Amen. Yeah, keep this man in prayer. You know, I pray that he's not in any kind of compromise, because that compromise sneak up in you. Amen. I pray he, if he hasn't already, that he comes back into that fire that he had when I used to listen to him when I was a kid. Amen. I love you guys. Let me know what you think in the comments, my brothers and sisters. I'm definitely going to be checking them, and definitely want to hear what you have to say. Amen. God bless. Shalom.